Hi everybody, how are you? I am Venkat Rao. Welcome to Wikipedia. Today I would like to show you two substances, copper sulfate and copper sulfate. Although these both are copper sulfates, but these are not looking same. Do you want to know what makes these two substances differ from each other? First of all, you watch an experiment conducted by my students and try to conclude it. Later, I will explain the remaining concept. Come on, let's get started.
A. Removing of water of crystallization. In this activity, we are going to prove CuSO4 contains water molecules in its crystals. Materials required: copper sulfate, water, dropper, test tube holder, spirit lamp, matchbox, etc. Procedure: take few crystals of copper sulfate in dry test tube. Observation: the water present in the crystals are evaporated and the blue color of salt turns to white. That means CuSO4 5H2O gives rise to CuSO4 plus 5H2O. On adding water to the anhydrous CuSO4, blue color of the crystals is restored. In this activity, we conclude that CuSO4 contains water in its crystals.
I hope you got this concept. From this activity, we came to know that what is the main thing which makes these two substances differ from each other. This water makes it possible for them to form crystals, and it is responsible for the shape of the crystals. The blue color copper sulfate crystals seems to be dry, contains water of crystallization. When these crystals are heated, the water present in these crystals is evaporated and turns the salt into white. When this white salt is moistened with water, the blue color reappears. Just like copper sulfate, the cobalt chloride, which is in pale pink color, turns into blue when it is heated. Do you want to know what is water of crystallization? Water of crystallization is a fixed number of water molecules chemically attached to one formula unit of salt in its crystalline form. This water of crystallization is also called as water of hydration. These salts are called as hydrated salts. Mostly, this fixed ratio of salt and water is represented in formula as 1 salt dot xH2O. We use dot here. In the case of copper sulfide, 5 water molecules are present in 1 formula unit of salt. So this can be represented as CSO4.5H2O. Do you want to have the list of hydrated salts? Here it is. Copper sulfate, also called as blue vitriol, CSO4-5H2O. Sodium sulfate, also called as glavosalt, Na2SO4-10H2O. Ferrous sulfate, also called as green vitriol, FeSO4-7H2O. Zinc sulfate, also called as white vitriol, ZnSO4-7H2O. Sodium carbonate is also called as washing soda, Na2CO3-10H2O. Cobalt chloride, COCl2-6H2O. Calcium sulfate, also called as gypsum, CaSO4-2H2O. That's all for today. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching.